हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर 3, दैट इज़ मोर अबाउट एम एस एक्सेस। मीन्स इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल अंडरस्टैंड अ मोर ऑप्शंस यूज्ड इन एम एस एक्सेस। ओके, नाउ सो टुडे आई विल स्टार्ट हाउ टू क्रिएट अ क्वेरी। ओके, नाउ द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज क्वेरी। A query is a database object which allows you to display specific records from a table or from two or more linked table, often based on a condition. That means you can see only those records which you want to display. Okay? How? By using a condition. If you will apply a condition, then according to your condition, a query object only display the selected records from one table or from more than one table, but they should be linked. They all tables should be linked. Okay. Next one, MS Access provides four types of query: select query, update query, cross tab query, and append query. Here we will learn to create the simplest type of query, the select query. Is that clear? Using the simple query wizard option. Okay, now look how to create simple query. Click on the start button, click on the Microsoft Office Access. After that, choose your database, Sacred Heart. After that, open your table. Okay, that is your previous table records. Okay, now what you want? You want to see a selected records through the simple query. Okay, through which option? Simple query wizard option. Okay, now first select the table. After that, choose create option. Now choose query wizard option. Okay, select the simple query wizard option. After that, click on the OK option. Then it will ask you which fields do you want to see. I want to see student ID, then I will click here, then it will be append here. Then I want to also see the name of the students, then I will click here, then it will be append here. And I want to see the maths marks only and science marks only. Okay, these four fields I want to see. Okay, clear? Then I will select only these four fields. If I want to select any one of them, then again I will click here, then it will move from this side. Okay, and when you click here, then it will be appended to this side. Okay, so only this field you will see in your fields. Okay, now click on the next option. Next and finish. Look here, you will see only the selected records of the students: student ID, student name, math and science. Only four fields you will see because of query wizard you will see only selected records. Okay, and look here, that is the name of the query wizard: student records query. That is your student records table. When you open it, then you can see all the records here. And if you want to see the selected records, then click on the your query wizard, a query table, then it will display you the selected records. Okay, that is the use of query. Got it? How to create a query? Next. Now the next topic is creating a query on a multiple tables. Okay, so first you have to create a multiple tables. In your database you can see there is only one tables. This is a query tables, but there is only one table, student records. Then you have to create at least two tables to create a query on multiple tables. Okay, now click on the new table option. Okay, that is a new table. Right click on it and choose design view. Write down the name of this table, what contact detail. Got it? Press OK button. After that, first field will be same, what student ID. Okay, write down here student ID first table, and this one will be text. Second, you want to display the name? No, because in this table you can store the records of the student with the help of their student ID. So in this table there is no need to save the name of the students again. Okay, on the behalf of the roll number you can identify the students, so you will not create a name table again in this table. You will not create a name field in this table again. Okay, so what you want to create a next field, student address, and address should be text. Now next one, mobile number, and mobile number should be number. Okay, and last one, date of birth, and date of birth will be what, which type of data type? Date and time. Okay, on a mobile number field apply a validation rule. Look here, what field size long integer, okay, I will tell you later, leave it. Okay, after that open your contact detail table and enter a few records. Open a student record table, copy this field from here. Okay, select this field and copy it. Open this field and paste it. Okay, here the field name is student ID. Copy it from here. In contact details, change the field name. Okay, student ID. Okay, now address, write down the address, house number 235, mobile number 12345678910. Date of birth, choose date of birth. Any date. Second one, house number
मोबाइल नंबर, डेट ऑफ बर्थ, एनी गार्बेज ले लूँ, हाउस नंबर, मोबाइल नंबर एंड डेट ऑफ बर्थ, ओके. हियर हाई आई हैव एंटर्ड फ्यू रिकॉर्ड्स ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स. ओके, आफ्टर दैट द लेफ्ट ऑफ द रिकॉर्ड्स यू विल फिल, आई विल नॉट फिल बिकॉज इट विल टेक अ टाइम. ओके, एंड आई कैन नॉट अपलोड द वीडियोज मोर देन 15 मिनट्स और 20 मिनट्स बिकॉज इट विल कंज्यूम अ लॉट ऑफ डेटा. सो इट इज़ डिफिकल्ट टू अपलोड ऑन द यूट्यूब. ओके, सो नाउ आफ्टर दैट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू अप्लाई अ क्वेरी देन यू हैव टू लिंक दिस टू टेबल. ओके, लुक हियर, सेटिंग और रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द टेबल्स, बिकॉज इफ यू विल नॉट क्रिएट अ रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन student records and contact details, you cannot create a query on multiple tables. If you want to create a query on multiple tables, you have to create a relationship between these two tables. Okay, got it better? Okay, now, so how to create a relationship? Okay, so first you will click on the database. Okay, look here, this option, relationship option. Click here. Okay, and on which table do you want to apply query? Contact detail, then you will add contact detail, and student records, then you will add student records. You want to apply your relationship on two tables, then you will add two tables, and after that close it. Okay, drag student ID and drop here. Okay, drag and drop here. Look, when you drag it and drop it, then this dialog box will open. It will ask you which two fields do you want to connect. I will select student ID and student ID because the student ID field in a contact records table and student ID fields in a student records table is common. Only this field is common in both tables. So if you want to create a relationship, then you will connect these two fields. Okay. Now click on the create option. After that you can see this symbol, that means our relationship has been created. After that, if you want to apply a query on multiple tables, you can do. First you have to save this one. Now it is saved. Now close all the tables. Okay, close all the tables. Now you want to create a multiple query. So first, you will select the tables. Okay, after you will click on the create option, choose query design option. In this time you will choose query design option. Now again this dialog box will open and it will ask you where you want to apply a query. I will select contact detail and student record. On these two tables I want to apply a query. Okay, now again it will ask you which how many fields do you want to see. I will select I want to see student ID. Double click on it and look here. When I double click on it, then you can see one fields is added. Now I want to see name. Double click on it, can see name is append. Now I want to see a mass marks, a science marks, and I want to see mobile number and date of birth. These five fields I want to see. Okay, after that save this query. Selected. Student. Okay, save it. When you save, then it will appear here. Save. Now you can see this one, selected student. Right click on it and open this one. Now you will see only six fields: student ID, student name, math marks, science marks, and mobile number and date of birth of those student which are filled. Okay, so you can see details are fetched from both tables and display in the front of you. Okay, so you can apply a query on multiple tables and you can fetch the records from two different tables. Okay, so there's no need to save the student name in other tables. If you have already saved that fields in student records, there's no need to save the student field, student name field in a contact details tables. Okay, because if you want to access the name of the students with the help of common field, that is student ID, you can fetch the records of the student name. Okay, so with the help of this common field student ID, you can create a multiple tables and you can create a multiple relation between the tables, and after that you can apply a query and you can access the records from different tables and you can get it on a single table. That is the use of multiple query. Okay, so next topic I will teach you in a next video. Have a good day. In the case of any doubts, you can ask me.